Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Newmarket Racecourse here on Saturday. It is May the 6th, 2017. Going to look at the stakes races on today's program, including the 2,000 guineas, which goes off as race number 4, the 335. But before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for racecourses around the world. And also join me for my Kentucky Derby preview video if you're interested in American racing. It's a great derby this year. Great 2,000 guineas this year. You have some very nice horses in it. I'm going to look at that race, but I'm going to be looking at races 2, 3, 4, and 6. So the 220, the 255, the 335, the 2,000 guineas, and the 445, which is race 6. So let's get on to it, starting off with the second race from Newmarket, the 220. It's the Long Holes Palace House Stakes. It's a Group 3 race here for Class 1 horses, going for a purse of $74,000. That's an American currency, so don't get confused. I just rounded up to the American currency, so I know. So it's just a little bit easier for me, instead of dealing with pounds and stuff. It's for 3-year-olds and upwards. Field of 16 horses going the distance of ground of 1,000 meters or 5 furlongs on the Rowley Mile course. My top pick in this one, I like the number 11 horse, Profitable. I'm going to go 11-13-1 in the tri-cast of the trifecta, 11-13-1, but my top pick, number 11, Profitable, 5-1, Adam Kirby for Clive Cox, 5-year-old horse at Invisible Spirit, most recently, on October the 2nd at Chantilly in France, 5 furlongs in the Prix de l'Alibi de Longchamp. This horse finished 7th by 2¾ lengths that day. Washington, D.C. ran a huge second place finish that day, and Marsha, who won, ran a huge race also. Marsha is running back in this one, and Washington, D.C. is running back in this one today. Those two, I think they're going to, Washington, D.C. had a very good start last time out. I think his starts in England haven't been that good, so I just think Profitable is the horse that can maybe beat these two. He finished 7th last time out. He didn't like the going that well. It just wasn't his day to win. Start before the Nunthorpe Stakes at New York, 5 furlongs August the 19th. Horse finished 6 by 6.5 lengths that day. He didn't quicken up at all. Mecca's Angel ran a little bit better. Wasn't his day to win. And then the July Cup here at Newmarket, 6 furlongs of July 9th on the July course. His horse finished 4th by 3¼ lengths that day behind Lamato. Lamato is a very nice horse. But, this horse just didn't quicken up at all that day either. But his last victory, I want to go back to the Kingstand Stakes at Royal Ascot last June the 14th. 5 furlongs in that Group 1. This horse won by a neck and had a great turn of foot. He had a very tough end of the year campaign last year. I think if he, with a fresh horse, he should run a very big one here today. At 5-1, I want to take my chances with this one closing at the end. He is breaking from stall number 1, so just keep that in mind. On a straight 1 mile, the Rally Mile is a straight mile and a quarter running. It doesn't, in my eyes, there can't be a post draw, that's a disadvantage. There is somehow, I read somewhere, but I think the one hole should be good. Watch out for this one. So to recap my picks for race number 2 from Newmarket, the second race at 220, it's the Long Holes Palace House Stakes. Gonna go with the 11 horse here, Profitable. I'm gonna go 11-13-1 in the tri-cast of the trifecta. To race number 3 now from Newmarket, the 255 is the Dunedin Jockey Club Stakes. Pardon me if I mispronounce any horse's name or a race name. Pardon that. It's Jockey Club Stakes here, going for Group 2 horses, for Class 1 horses also. Purse, $123,000. It's for 4-year-olds and upwards. Field of 6 horses going the distance of ground to 2,400 meters or 1.5 miles on the turf course. My top pick in this one, I like the number 6 horse, 7th Heaven. I'm going to go 6-4-1 in the tri-cast of the trifecta, 6-4-1, but my top pick, number 6, 7th Heaven, 6-5, Ryan Moore for Aiden O'Brien for the Coolmore Group. This horse has one start under her belt already this year. That came on March 25th at Maidan on a very, it says good turf course, but it was more towards yielding, 1.5 miles in the Dubai Shahima Classic. Facing the boys that day, this horse had a decent second place finish by 2¼ lengths behind Jack Hobbs. This horse, she needed the race, but she ran a hell of a second place finish against those tough horses. She's jumping down in class here today. Second off the layoff, she should run a very big race. Start before here in America, actually out in Southern California, November the 5th at Santa Anita, 1¼ in the Breeders' Cup Filly Mare Turf. Horse finished 4th by 1¾ lengths that day. She just didn't quicken up at all that day. Queen's Trust, another European horse, ran a very nice race, and Lady Eli ran a decent second place finish, but this horse just didn't quicken up that day. Wasn't her day to win. It was on a quick turnaround. You know, it's 2 weeks earlier, she ran October the 15th at Ascot, mile and a half in the British Champions Filly Mare Stakes. Horse finished fifth by 5 1/4 lengths. As the favorite, then show up. Journey won that day and ran well, but this horse just didn't quicken at all. But before that, she did win the Yorkshire Oaks at York. She won the Irish Oaks and finished sixth in the Investec Oaks behind Minding. I think here today, second off the layoff, she should have a very good run. So to recount my bets now for race number 3 from Newmarket, it's the 255. It's the Jockey Club Stakes. Going to go with the 6 horse here, 7th Heaven. I'm going to go 6-4-1 in the TriCast or the Trifecta. To race number 4 now from Newmarket, the 335, it's the Quipo 2,000 Guineas. It's a Group 1 race for Class 1 horses, going for a purse of $615,000. That's in American currency, so don't get confused. It's for 3-year-old colts and geldings here. Field of 10 horses going the distance of ground, 1,600 meters or 1 mile here in the 2,000 Guineas for this 3-year-old colts. My top pick in this one, I like the number 3, Churchill. I think he looks very hard to beat on paper. He had a very good 2-year-old campaign, and, you know, he should run a very big one. So I'll use him as a top pick, number 3, Churchill. Going to go 3-1-5 in the TriCast of the Trifecta. 3-1-5, but my top pick, number 3, Churchill. Like I said many times, 7-5. Aiden O'Brien trains Ryan Moore's on the Coolmore Group owned 3-year-old colt out of Galileo. You know, last year was pretty perfect other than one blemish in Ireland, but, you know, last year, October the 8th at Newmarket, 7 furlongs in the Dewhurst Stakes. Horse won by 1 1/4 lengths with 73 cents to the dollar, but this horse just had a great turn of foot in the final furlong. I think the longer the distance goes, this horse should really relish it and should really do well. You know, I think this horse will be a great 1 mile quarter horse, but you know, he ran very well, beating stablemate Lancaster Bomber that day. Lancaster Bomber is running back into this one, but I don't think he's good enough to win. But start 4 in Ireland, Curra, on the 11th of September, 7 furlongs in the Vincent O'Brien National Stakes. Horse won by 4 3/4 lengths that day. You know, another easy victory, quickened up nicely, just an all-around great race. And then the Futurity Stakes occur, 7 furlongs on August 21st. Horse won by 2 lengths, another easy victory. You know, won the Japan Racing Tyro Stakes at Leopardstown, and won, you know, won at Royal Ascot last year very nicely also in his first career win. You know, like I said, the longer the distance goes to, I think the mile to 1 1/4 miles will be really suiting this horse a lot. If he's fresh enough, I think he's going to run a big one here today. So watch out for this one. So to recount my bets for the 4th, the 335 from Newmarket, it's the 2,000 Guineas. Going to go with the 3-horse Churchill. I'm going to go 3-1-5 in the TriCast of the Trifecta. Now we're going to skip over race number 5 and head on to race number 6. The 6th race, the 445 from Newmarket, is the Havana Gold Newmarket Stakes. It's listed stakes for Class 1 horses here, going for a purse of $49,000. It's for 3-year-old colts and geldings only. Field of 5 horses going the distance of ground of 1 mile and 1 1/4 or 2,000 meters on the turf course. My top pick in this one, I like the number 1 horse, Kaladi. Pardon me if I mispronounced the horse's name. I'm going to go 1-4 in the forecast. Or the exact 1-4, but my top pick, number 4, Kaladi, even money here, 1-1. Frankie Dettori for John Gosden. This horse is coming off a very nice win a few weeks ago here at Craven Meeting at Newmarket, 1 1/4, a mile and 1/8 in the listed stakes. Horse won by neck that day, quickened up very nicely, and he had a great race, second off the layoff. Start before Class 3 handicap at Doncaster, 1 1/4, April 2nd. Horse finished 3rd by 2 1/4 lengths, was the 7-2 favorite that day. He didn't quicken up at all. He needed that race. I think second off the layoff, he proved that he needed the race. He won very nicely. Third off the layoff, he should be even fresher. He should run a big one here today. You know, last year at the end of the year, he ran 10th at Doncaster, 1 mile in a Class 2 handicap. He won by 1 1/4 lengths. Another easy victory. And he won a Class 4 maiden race at Goodwood, 1 mile, August 26th. Won by 2 1/2 lengths. Easy victory, just over evens that day. In this spot, I think this horse should have a very good run, so watch out for him. So to recap my bets for the 6 from Newmarket, the 445, it's Savannah Gold Newmarket Stakes. Going to go with the 1 horse. Going to go 1-4 in the forecast or the exacta. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. Join me for my Kentucky Derby preview video, and also join me tomorrow for the 1,000 Guineas. Good luck, everybody.